It's week 9 of the 2024 season, and we've got C.D. Lamb. No one's been busier this season as he currently paces the NFL in receptions. It's the Cowboys and the Falcons, and it's all up next.
Thank you to Trey Mosley for the introduction. We are indeed excited to welcome you to another edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Thanks for having us in. Mike Tirico, Greg Olson. Greg, it's that time of the year. A little bit more urgency. The calendar page turns to November. I don't know who the good teams are. The midpoint of the NFL season, always a great time to take a step back and look ahead to what's down the road for us.
Yeah, no doubt. And I always felt, you know, even as a player, that you never really knew how good you were as a team or how good
The punter, Bradley Pinion, will handle kickoff duties. And off we go here in Atlanta. Kevontae Turpin on the return. And a solid run back there. He'll get this out past the 30-yard line. Cowboys coming out. As usual, it's Dak Prescott leading the way. Led the NFL in touchdown passes, Greg, a season ago. Already his ninth year at the helm for the Cowboys.
One of the best parts of the week, Mike, is when we have an opportunity to sit down and visit with these guys during the production meetings. And the thing that we both came away with was, while he was happy with the overall performance of his team a week ago, you could tell that lone interception left a bit of a bad taste in his mouth. He called that errant pass unacceptable. He doesn't plan on having too many of those in this one, and look for him to be a little bit more careful with the ball as he tries to get his team to another victory here today.
Second down, Prescott. He's got the open man. That's Jalen Tolbert. And he's down inside the 40-yard line.
This may look like a simple connection, Mike, just pitch and catch, but I can promise you the amount of time these two guys have spent together on the practice field, in the meeting rooms, just getting on the same page, seeing the game through the same set of eyes, it makes what's pretty difficult seem a lot easier.
We'll go three tight ends here on first and 10. And on the carry, this is Ezekiel Elliott. What more could you ask for on first down? Nice run of 8, setting up second and short. There you get a look at his numbers on the ground a week ago as a part of their victory. Here's second and 2. A shotgun snap for Prescott. That's to the left side. He's got Ferguson. And this takes him into the red zone. He's brought down inside the 20-yard line. On first and 10, Prescott. The open man is Tolbert. And the Cowboys are going to have a first and goal coming up as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Here's a run. And he will fight his way to the end zone. Ezekiel Elliott. Touchdown, Cowboys. Exactly the way they scripted this one. A beautiful opening drive, Greg. Able to find the end zone on the game's first possession.
And Mike, the word that comes to mind looking at that drive is execution, and that's exactly what they talked about all week long. They wanted to come out early in this game and establish an early rhythm, and that's exactly what they did with that touchdown drive.
So now, after the touchdown, out is Aubrey to kick this one away. Ray-Ray McCloud on the return. And he is stopped at 25. The drive will begin there. The Falcons, led out by their quarterback, Kirk Cousins. One of the big moves in the offseason. Atlanta acquiring Cousins in free agency. He had 6 years in Washington, the last 6 in Minnesota. And now he begins his run this season with the Falcons.
I think the biggest thing that stood out from last week's game was when they went into the game with an initial plan, how quickly were they able to get away from that when they realized it wasn't working? I think they got a lot of unscouted looks, meaning the defense threw a lot of exotic looks at them, blitzes, different fronts and coverages, maybe things they didn't work on all week. So the key this week is understand what is the defense looking to do today and how fast can we make those adjustments if we're not having early success.
Finding room at midfield. And he'll be taken down, but they are in business inside the 30-yard line.
Well, they've come out swinging here on this opening drive through the air, and that's exactly what they wanted to do. Generate some early chunk plays and try to get some points.
The Break the Huddle coming up now for first and 10. And here's Bijan. And a good job following his blockers, a gain of 7. It'll be second down. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. Complete. Former first-round pick Drake London with the catch. Now they are in business inside the 15-yard line. Space getting tight here, down to the 13-yard line. They work first and 10. Working out of the gun, it's Cousins. He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
You can't fault the quarterback on this one, Mike. He really didn't even have much of an opportunity. By the time he hit the top of his drop and got his eyes downfield, the defense was all over him, and he really had no choice but to just get that ball out of his hand and live to play another snap.
And the Falcons are looking at a first and goal as he's taken down at the 2-yard line. Following the completion, we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player. This opening drive, it has been a work of art. Now, can they put the finishing touches on? It's first and goal. And he'll get 2 on this one before being taken down. The ball a little closer now. It is second and goal. To throw is Cousins. And that one is incomplete. Penalty flag down. Back in the backfield in the area of holding. From a little further back, here's second and goal. On the handoff, it's Robinson. And he'll be taken down, let's call it the 7-yard line. And here comes third and goal. Now, Cousins. Trying to reach for the goal line, but he's going to come up just short. Wow, it's going to set up fourth down.
You could tell that this defense was ready for this exact play call. They know that they're going to give their quarterback a chance both through the air and on the ground with his legs. They do a nice job stopping him short of the goal line to force fourth down.
They'll go. It's Robinson. And he's not going anywhere. Stuffed behind the line. They have turned it over on downs.
And what a job here by the defensive line. They've got to hold their ground. Any sort of push by the offense is going to result in a touchdown. But here, the defense comes through with a huge goal line stand, and they're able to keep this offense out of the end zone.
Set to go now on first and 10. Back near his goal line, Prescott to the outside, looked in by Lamb.
Certainly not the biggest play of the day, but a good example of picking up positive yardage, staying ahead of the chains by a well-timed ball and a well-timed route.
On second down, it's Dak. And that's going to be a first down, a pickup of 9.
One of the easiest ways to negate these really good pass rushes in the NFL, Mike, is just to simply get the ball out of the quarterback's hand as fast as possible. And sometimes it's by design, sometimes it's based on need. But really nice job there by the quarterback, getting into the hands of his receiver and then see what he can do after the catch.
And out of bounds he goes, just shy of midfield. That one good for 29. A couple of first downs, and the football's out to the 48-yard line as they come up first and 10. In motion, Lamb.
They will not get this one off. It'll be a delay of game.
Still first down.
Go play action. It's Prescott. That one downfield for Cooks. That is knocked away. Incomplete. Good coverage there. Defensively all over him. And it'll be second down. Hand off here to Zeke. And that'll go for a gain of about four. Caden Ellis in on that stop. A tough spot here. Third and long. From the shotgun, it's Dak. And this is going to be incomplete. That is great work there, making things difficult defensively. It'll set up a fourth down. Cowboys special teams unit heads out for the punt. Ray McLeod, deep to return. And no chance of a run back here. This one's going to sail out of bounds. The Falcons offense ready to see what they can do on their second possession. They trail here by a touchdown as this drive will start with a first down. He'll try to push forward. He'll wind up getting 3 yards with that one. It is Jordan Lewis who brought him down. They face second down and seven. Pitts is the man in motion. Now a second down throw for... The pressure gets there, and down he goes back inside the 20-yard line. Micah Parsons, too tough to stop, gets in to bring him down. On third down, it's Robinson. An injured player on the field, and that is Micah Parsons, who needs some medical attention. So as they look at the injured player, we'll take a timeout. So on fourth down, the Falcons bring on Bradley Pinion to punt. Kevontae Turpin to return for the Cowboys. Whoa! And he's going to be hit and dropped right away. That's great coverage there. Winds up with nothing on the return. First and 10. The drive starts with a run, and it's Elliott. He'll work his way ahead for a gain of about four. Here's second and six. Now Prescott. A short throw caught by Ferguson. Well, he's brought down. That pass is going to pick up four and bring up third down. On play action. Oh, the blitz overwhelming the offensive line, and down he goes.
The best thing they did here, Mike, is keep their rush lane integrity. What that means is you have to rush the quarterback as a unit. Keep him in the pocket. Keep him on that X. And when you do, man, he becomes a sitting duck for this pass rush.
And a fair catch is taken. It is just inside the 20-yard line. On first down, Cousins. Left side in the hands of London. And he'll be taken down. And that's going to do it. That's the last play of the first quarter. From the 34 now, it's first and 10. Throwing is Cousins. To the right, that's Pitts. And that keeps him ahead of schedule. That's a first down completion of 7 yards. Here's a second and three forthcoming. At the 41-yard line. Cousins. That's caught. It's Charlie Werner, the tight end. And it'll be a short pickup. That's not enough for the first down. Here's third down and a few inches. They'll try to run for it with Robinson. The defense all over that. Met him in the backfield, stopped in his tracks, and it sets up fourth down.
The idea here for this offense is you're not really thinking necessarily touchdown. You're thinking first down. Let's get a fresh set of downs here and reset. But in this case, they suffer a loss, and it brings up fourth down.
And good coverage by the punt team. They stop him before he can get any return cranked up. Here's Dak Prescott, and the Cowboy offense set to go again. He's building a case for the MVP. He is the leader in the NFL in touchdown passes as we move into the back half of the season. Dak to fire here, complete to Cooks. That's a nice pickup on a first down throw. It's a gain of 8. They'll come to the line now on 2nd and 2. To the right, here's Elliott. And that'll be a gain of 2 and a first down.
This is a situation that play callers love to be in, Mike. They have all their options on the table. 2nd and short, play action pass, you can run. In this case, they choose to keep it on the ground, play it safe, pick up the first down.
And he's going to be running out of bounds, but not until he gets down to the 40-yard line. A huge play for Dallas, 35 yards.
Those are the explosive pass plays that this team is going to continue to mine all day. And you could see pre-snap, the quarterback loved his matchup. He allowed his receiver to work downfield. Perfect throw, and now sets them up to try to see if they can finish this drive off with some points.
Here's Elliott. And he surges forward for a gain of about 5. They'll break the huddle. It's 2nd and 5. They'll stick with Elliott, and he'll get forward for about 1 yard. It is Ryan Neal there to bring him down. Here's a 3rd down and 4. Operating from the gun, here's Dak. And that is incomplete.
A rare miss for a quarterback that we've seen really come out on fire throughout this entire contest. I mean, his completion percentage, Mike, is well above league average, and frankly, it's really the biggest reason why they find themselves out in front.
Aubrey's kick is good, and the Cowboys will extend to a 10-0 lead.
And this is what you want. I mean, you clearly have the advantage, but you want to continue to apply pressure. Can you score every time you get the ball? They're able to do that here. They tack on 3 and extend their lead.
And he'll work this one past the 25 to right about the 28-yard line. The Falcons offense starting to trot out for this next possession. And nothing doing from the offense just yet. Down 10-0 as they come up with 1st and 10. He's got this to Bijan Robinson. And he's brought down after a gain of 6 on 1st down. They'll come up now for 2nd down and 4. Throwing now, Cousins. That's going to be dropped underneath for Robinson. And it'll be a short pickup. That's not enough for the 1st down. They'll look to pick this up 3rd and 1 yard. Here's Robinson. Heading outside, going to be close. It's going to depend on the spot. They're going to mark him short, and it is going to be 4th down.
All the qualities that make a good safety are seen on display on this play. Speed, pursuit, and then the intensity and the strength at the point of contact for the tackle to keep this ball carrier to no gain. That is a complete safety play.
A fair catch signaled, and they'll have it just outside their own 20. So So first and 10 now. They'll start from the 22. Prescott. His pass right side taken in by Cooks. And he's brought down after a gain of 6 on first down. They'll work now on second and 4. A shotgun snap for Prescott. Over the middle to his tight end Ferguson. And he'll be taken down up at the 40-yard line. They'll come up here first and 10. Throwing is Prescott. That's to the middle of the field and caught by Cooks.
It takes a certain guy in that slot position to be willing and able to go across the middle of the defense on those in-breaking routes. You can tell this guy, he doesn't care. He is fearless going across the middle, and he's able to secure a nice catch.
And they're going to work this down inside the 45.
The goal of every offense, Mike, is to find a way to establish a balance between the run and the pass. But some success here early on the ground will open up things as the game unfolds for the quarterback in this passing game.
Open man, that's the veteran, Cooks. He's going to be taken down at about the 30.
It's like a textbook, methodical, efficient NFL drive. 4 for 4 throwing the ball, mixing in some run. You're just marching the ball downfield at your will, and they get a fresh set of downs now to see if they can convert this nice drive into some points.
Dak going to throw it here on first down. He runs with it, and he's able to gain yardage out of this one before he slides. Second and 7. Prescott now. That's into the hands of the veteran Cooks. And they'll hold him to a gain of just a couple and sets up third down. Here's Prescott. And that is incomplete, but a penalty flag comes in. That might make this a first down. To throw is Dak. This one caught by CeeDee Lamb. And he's brought down after a gain of 6 on first down. They'll run it here with Zeke. Only a couple on that one. It'll set up third down. 2 minutes remain here in this first half. Greg and I back to Atlanta in a moment. They've moved the ball well here, but now face third and 2. Here's Dak to throw. Open man, left side. He's got it. And he goes out of bounds at the 3, and from there, it's going to be first and goal.
What an impressive drive this has really been, and it's a combination of big plays and third down conversions. Now after that last third down pickup, it's first and goal. They got a chance to finish this really impressive drive and come away with 6.
This has been some kind of march downfield. Now, can they pay it off with 6? It's first and goal. He'll work forward for about 3. It's second down. They'll run. Here's Elliott. And this time he will work his way into the end zone. Ezekiel Elliott. Touchdown, Dallas. 2 touchdowns for him in the game. Numbers 10 and 11 on the year. Aubrey, good with the extra point. And the Cowboys move further out in front. It is now 17 to nothing. So now, after the touchdown, out is Aubrey to kick this one away. McLeod now to return. He's across the 20, taken down just shy of the 25. Falcons offense make their way out to take over once more. The next drive about to get going as we check out what's coming up a little later here in Week 9. Tonight, Sunday Night Football. It'll be the Jaguars and Eagles coming up at 8:20 Eastern Time in Philadelphia. And then tomorrow night, Election Night Eve, Monday Night Football as the Bucks and Chiefs. That's a rematch of Super Bowl 55 at 8:15 Eastern, 7:15 in KC.
Cousins now to throw on first down. The coverage too strong that time. The ball batted away and incomplete.
He'll try again here, second and 10. Here's Cousins. Now a screen going to be set up for Robinson. And he's going to be brought down up past the 45. Now a timeout, Atlanta. That's their first. And they'll stop it just over a minute remaining in this first half.
He's got his man. It's Mooney. And he's close to another first down as he's brought down just shy of the marker. Cousins now on second down. That'll be caught by McCloud.
That's two catches on this drive. This one for 10 yards and a first down.
From the shotgun, it's Cousins. He's got it inside the five. He is in. Darnell Mooney. Touchdown, Falcons. It's his third touchdown on the year.
This is kind of the feast or famine anytime a defensive coordinator dials up a man pressure. And when you don't get home, it just puts so much stress on your secondary, Mike. They feel like they're out there defending their man for an eternity. And the quarterback had his opportunity to find his matchup, good protection up front, and he just couldn't hold up in coverage long enough, and they give up a big touchdown.
Still a little time. Final minute of this first half. We'll see if they can do anything with this kickoff that is coming their way. And they'll bring him down just shy of the 30-yard line. They'll break the huddle. Coming up now for first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Dak. He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
At this level, you just would expect a little bit better execution and accuracy on those intermediate throws. I think he had an opportunity there for a nice pickup. Off target, off rhythm, and ends up getting away from him.
His fifth catch of the afternoon. Good for a first down.
Every once in a while, it just comes down to you need somebody in the huddle to just make a play. And it wasn't a whole lot fancy here. The quarterback just dumps the ball down, a quick underneath completion. And then really, it's the yards after catch that did the rest. And that's what it takes. You're not always going to have the perfect play. You're not always going to dial up the perfect play against the perfect look. Sometimes players need to make plays, and that was a good one there.
Now a second down throw for Prescott. A short throw caught by Ferguson. And they'll move this one down inside the 40-yard line. Ball rests at the 37. It's first and 10. Now, Prescott. That's to Ferguson once again. And they bring him down inside the 25-yard line. Cowboys going to use their third and final timeout, as that'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. First down, Prescott. He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
Up until that incompletion, they've done a really nice job on this drive, Mike, picking up fresh sets of downs. And typically, throwing the ball on first down is a great way to do it. But now they find themselves in second and 10. Do you keep it in the air and try to get the first down here? Or is the idea to just make third down manageable and take your chances picking up a key third down?
So, still the matter of 6 seconds remaining in this half. And the kick's away. The return team gonna let that one go. It'll go through the end zone. It's a touchback. On first and 10, Cousins. He's gonna take a shot down the field. And penalty flags come in as it winds up incomplete, but no doubt there was contact there. Out is Youngway Koo to try the field goal. This is going to be from 53 yards out. Koo's kick is good. And the Falcons will cut into that lead. So we reach halftime, and the visiting Cowboys are in front as we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
All right, Michael, we'll get back to you and Greg in just a little bit. For now, plenty of early action in the 1 o'clock Eastern window to get you caught up on. So let's get to it. We'll start in the Meadowlands, an NFC East battle that pits Washington against the New York Football Giants. And it's the visiting side who have the lead in that one. The rookie Jaden Daniels taking number 2 overall with 2 touchdown passes. From there, we stay in the Empire State. We head up to Buffalo to check on the Bills. And in that one, it's the visiting Dolphins who are out in front. 3 Tua Tagovailoa touchdown passes there. Lastly, let's head to Paycor Stadium in Cincinnati to see what's happening with the Bengals. As you can see, the score there in the second quarter. The Raiders trying to gut this one out, as it would be a good victory for them if they could get it. We saw the vet with plenty left, Ezekiel Elliott, putting together a strong first half. He chipped in a couple of touchdown runs as he was running with determination right from the word go.
All right, Coach, thank you very much. We welcome you back. It is quarter number 3. McLeod now to return. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. Here's Bijan Robinson and the Falcon offense set for their next drive. And really, he has not produced a whole lot of highlights as we thought about coming in, that he could be a featured back in this one. Instead, no running lanes, no room to operate, stuck at the line of scrimmage, and generally taking this offense out of its flow. So they come to the line for first down and 10. The drive will begin here with a run by Robinson. And that'll be a pickup of 3. Another run here for Robinson. And he'll weave his way down close to that first down. Going to come up just a little shy. It's going to be third down and short. They'll go again with Robinson. Robinson, a first down and more. And he's going to be brought down, but not until he gets inside the 35.
That's the mindset I just love seeing from a running back, Mike. His eyes weren't just on that first down marker. They were on getting that first and some on top of it. That's pretty impressive.
Slot man in motion left. And he can't hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. What a good job defensively to meet him just as the ball was arriving. And it'll be second down. They send a receiver in motion left. And they'll run out of the gun. Here comes Robinson. And he is crushed in the backfield. Defenders firing through. Shut it down right away for a loss of yardage. Third and long. Working out of the gun, it's Cousins. That's caught left side by Pitts. Pretty good effort on that one. It will not be enough. It's going to bring up fourth down. Out is Youngway Koo to try the field goal. Spotted at the 35, this a 45-yard attempt. He is 2 for 2. That kick is good. And the Falcons are able to get it back within a score.
And I can tell you firsthand, Mike, when you find yourself trailing in a game, you don't feel very good about coming away with field goals. But in this case, it does get them a little bit closer and cut into this deficit.
Terrific return. He's taken down just shy of midfield. There's CeeDee Lamb heading back out there with the rest of his Cowboys teammates.
He's been filling up the stat sheet on a weekly basis, hasn't he? You get a look at where he ranks in terms of receptions by a wideout.
Prescott on first down. A quick slant taken by Lamb. And they're going to work this down inside the 45. A fresh set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. Now give to Zeke out of the gun. And they'll take this down inside the 35.
This is where you have to be careful, Mike. You find yourself winning in the second half. Human instinct says, all right, let's just sit on the ball and protect the lead and let the clock run out. You can't do that. Stay aggressive. Do what got you here. Continue to mix the run with the...
No chance at all. He'll go down.
And now we're seeing the game kind of go back and forth. Each team trading blows, trying to establish control over the other. Nice chunk play on the previous play. The defense responds back with a sack, and we see which team can establish a little bit more of this control as the game unfolds.
Work to do now as they come up on second and long. Go play action. It's Prescott. His fullback releasing, and he's going to bring it in.
So I don't think his fullback was his primary option on that play, but a really nice job by the quarterback working quickly through his progression, getting the ball down to his big fullback, and he's able to pick up a nice game.
He's got his tight end. That's Ferguson. His 8th reception of the game, and good for a first down. First down. From out of the gun, it's a run with Elliott. And he does not want to go down. Somehow he turned that into a gain of 6. On second down, it's Dak. That's over the middle, but it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to CeeDee Lamb. And it's going to bring up a third down. Prescott. This one is hauled in. Are the feet in bounds? Yes. Jalen Tolbert. Touchdown, Cowboys. Tight spaces down there. Things happen quick. Greg, a quick decision and great execution for the score.
You're exactly right, Mike. Down here this close to the goal line, everybody's clock has to speed up. Not only the quarterback processing to get the ball out of his hand, but you have to win as a receiver quickly and give the quarterback somewhere to go with the ball. It was that quickness at the line of scrimmage that led to that touchdown.
The kick is good. Makes the score Cowboys 27, Falcons 13.
So now, after the touchdown, out is Aubrey to kick this one away. Here comes a return from the 5. And he'll be brought down right around the 25-yard line. Now the return man is a bit slow getting up after that kick. As the athletic training staff looks at him, we'll step away for a moment. From the 25, they'll go to work, first and 10. To throw is Cousins. Over the middle, that's his tight end, Pitts. And they'll mark him down just shy of the 40. Following the completion, we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player. And as the medical staff looks him over, we'll step aside. You have a tight end motioning left here. It's a give up the middle to Robinson. And he finds a little bit of space. He'll take this forward for a gain of 4. Here's a 2nd and 6.
It's now 2nd and 6.
Now, Cousins. He'll get that to Kadarius Hyde. And he's down inside the 40-yard line.
Whatever they've talked about in the locker room at the halftime break seems to have worked. They've come out with a new established energy. You could see it when they took the field. Now this offense seems to be building on it, because with that chunk play, just a little bit of rhythm that they can build off of. They got a long way to go to get back into this game, but so far off to a good start.
They'll send their tight end left. On first down, Cousins. That one is caught by Mooney. And it'll be taken down at the 25-yard line. Here's 1st and 10.
That's another Falcons. 1st and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Cousins. To the left side in the hands of London. And he's close to another first down as he's brought down just shy of the marker. A good spot here, 2nd and 1 yard. They run over center with Robinson. And the Falcons are going to have a 1st and goal coming up. They try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
A huge advantage to red zone offense is the ability to run the ball. In this case, I thought he was going to score. He takes it all the way down inside the 2, sets up 1st and goal.
They'll run with Robinson. And he will take this one across into the end zone. Bijan Robinson, touchdown Atlanta. Greg, sometimes we say it too often, that was an important drive. That one really felt important for them to edge a little bit closer.
Yeah, now the question is, Mike, yeah, the offense does their job, but can the defense get a stop? They've got to continue to get the ball back to their offense. Let them build on that previous drive, because they've still got some work to do.
The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. On the return, here's Turpin. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. The Cowboys offense and Dak Prescott set to take over again, and he's had it going in the first half. Really had his way with the secondary. They have been powerless to stop him. Now they're trying to keep it going. Catch is made there on the left side by Cooks. And he'll be brought down up around the 38-yard line.
Well, any fear they might have had that they'd come out of the halftime break flat has completely gone out the window. They're not content, Mike, here, just having the lead. They're looking to extend it. A couple more plays like that.
And the rush gets home. He'll go down. They got him.
The offense goes from feeling really good about the previous play with a real nice pickup to then on the ensuing play ending up going the complete opposite direction. Really nice job here by the defense immediately getting back on track. And what do the coaches say? Just play the next play, and that's exactly what they did.
2nd down, Prescott. There's that man again, another catch. Well, they'll get some of the sack yardage back, but it's still going to leave them with 3rd down. A shotgun snap for Prescott. The throw on the run is complete.
Really well done here by the defense, Mike, executing this zone defense, and they've got to be able to pattern read. You're not just going to drop back to a spot and just play like a robot. Based on what the receivers do off the line, the defenders have different rules of where their zones move to. Well, they had that one dialed in right from the jump, and they were able to stop that play really before it got started.
Here comes the Atlanta offense now. They get set to take over once more.
And time again, Greg, the yards on the ground have been very difficult to come by.
Yeah, and it really goes against conventional wisdom, Mike. You hear so often everyone talk about you run the ball to open up the pass, and really that's not necessarily true. Oftentimes when you're having trouble on the ground, the best way to open things up underneath is by passing the ball, and that could be a variety of ways. Throwing it downfield, screen passes, swing passes. Just get the ball into the hands of your playmakers and open things up. You see so many teams wait till third down to execute their screen game, but I like in this case the play caller changes things up. He uses the screen game on first down, which will have an effect on this pass rush going forward. How aggressive do they want to get after the quarterback? Because they got that screen play still in the back of their head.
First and 10. So, three quarters now in the books. Back with more after the break. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. Cousins now to throw on first down. Looking middle there, but it's incomplete.
It's rare to see an offense that finds themselves trailing and say, well, their quarterback's been actually one of their biggest bright spots. Usually that doesn't go hand in hand, so it's a little surprising to see him miss a throw like that on a day where he's completed passes at a highly efficient rate.
Big play coming up. This is third down. They're going to motion the tight end over here. On third down, they'll set up to throw.
They got there in a hurry, didn't they, Mike? I mean, luckily for him, he saw that free rusher coming and at the very least was able to get that ball out to prevent the sack.
To return, it is Turpin. And he'll be brought down. Short return. And they'll take over there. So now here are the Cowboys. Their offense ready to make their way back onto the field. They lead by a touchdown as this drive begins with first and 10. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. Can't ask for much more. 22 yards on the first play of the drive.
And this is the point of the game, Mike, where you really can start leaning on your run game and try to close this game out. You've got the lead, you're in the fourth quarter, and they're able to pop off a big run.
A first down throw for Prescott. And he can't hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. What a good job defensively to meet him just as the ball was arriving. And it'll be second down. From the shotgun, it's Dak. The open man is Tolbert. And he'll be very close to a first down. Won't quite have enough, but now a much more advantageous spot. This crowd into it now as we get to third down. He'll get this one complete. To Schoonmaker.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Offense.
You only get a 1 yard buffer from the line of scrimmage for these old linemen. That time he strayed a little
still
too far.
Down.
And it draws the flag. On third down, Prescott. He's got his man. Right side. It's complete. 10 catches now in the game. They've gone his way early and often. That one for a first down. They'll throw again. Dak. That's to Ferguson once again. And he's into the end zone. That might be the knockout punch. Jake Ferguson, touchdown, Dallas. everything you want to do right there, Greg, in the fourth quarter. Get the ball with the lead and extend it to a two-score advantage.
Yeah, and I think this just might end up being too much to overcome. You said it. Once you get a two-score lead this late in the fourth quarter, there's just not enough possessions to be had to claw yourself back in it.
On for the PAT is Aubrey. The kick is good. The Cowboys will open it up even further here in this fourth quarter. So now, after the touchdown, out is Aubrey to kick this one away. This will be returned from the six. Nice job by the return team as he takes it across the 30-yard line. The Falcons offense and running back Bijan Robinson headed back onto the field. And he has put in a full game's work and then some. Just an incredible performance on the ground to this point in the fourth quarter. And he's brought down after a gain of a couple. Second down and eight.
A gain of two brings up second and eight.
Throwing now, Cousins. Now a screen going to be set up for Robinson. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. They get an even 20 on that one. First down, Atlanta.
And this is a tricky part of the game for any defense. You find yourself protecting a late lead. And the age-old question is, do you remain aggressive? Do you try to just keep the ball from being thrown over your head and make everything be tackled and played in front of you? That's what every defensive coordinator struggles with. So they can't get too soft here as they try to hold on to this lead here late. Trying to catch the defense off guard with this designed quarterback run. Doesn't go down for a sack, but either way, defense was ready for it, able to bring the quarterback down for a loss.
Cousins now on second down. He's got his man, it's Mooney. And he'll be taken down after a gain of nine, and third down coming up.
A gain of nine brings up third and three.
They'll run here.
Bijan Robinson, ball carrier. Tackle made at the 38-yard line. A gain of two on the play. Brings up fourth and one.
Trailing late, they've got to go here. It's fourth down. They'll go. It's Robinson. And he's going to have a Falcons first down. Oh, they take a chance there on fourth and one, but it's a gain of three and a new set of downs. Working out of the gun, it's Cousins. And he can't hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. What a good job defensively to meet him just as the ball was arriving. And it'll be second down. Here's Cousins. Short throw taken by Pitts. And they're going to be set up in the red zone. They've got it inside the 15.
It's been tough sledding for this offense all day today, Mike, but especially here in the second half. So they are just in desperate need of a spark, just something to get their offense into a little bit of a rhythm if they want to have any chance to find themselves back into this game here late.
Space getting tight here, down to the 13-yard line. They work first and 10. He'll be hit as he throws, and that one will wind up incomplete. Could not step into the throw that time. It'll bring up second down. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. He'll get this to McCloud. And they'll work this close to a first down, maybe just a tad short. Cousins out of the gun on third down. To the end zone, it's intercepted. Picked off by Deron Bland.
So much of that play comes down to the defender's positioning. Being able to get himself to a spot to get his hands on the ball and a chance at that pick. Mike, when that ball was thrown, me and you are sitting here saying, that's a touchdown. And instead, they force a turnover, and now their offense is back on the field.
The Cowboys offense and veteran Ezekiel Elliott making their way back out. And as we look at the highlights, you see it's been tough to stop him here today. A couple of touchdowns in this ball game. He has, without a doubt, been the driving force in this offense so far. The drive begins at the 20. Here's first and 10. Pistol now for Prescott. Over the middle to his tight end, Ferguson. And he'll be taken down up past the 40-yard line.
This is a tale as old as time, Mike. It seems that anytime a team forces a takeaway, fumble, or interception, the ensuing drive starts with a shot, a deep play in the air to try to seize on some of that momentum. We just saw a great example of it here.
Here's second and nine. Operating from the gun, here's Dak. And that's going to be a first down. A pickup of nine. Following the completion, we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player. The training staff going to look, and we'll step out for a moment. Set to go now on first and 10. Now Elliott, and he'll take this forward for about three. It's second down. We'll go play action. It's Prescott. He's got a man open. That's Tolbert. And they bring him down inside the 25-yard line.
An interesting decision there by the play caller to put this ball in the air. Mike, you're up by two scores. Traditional wisdom says, hey, we're up by two scores late in the fourth quarter. We've got to keep this clock moving. We don't want to risk an incompletion. Now, they convert. They're able to secure the catch and pick up a fresh set of downs. That's going to enable them to continue to burn more clock. And without a stop, their opponent's not going to get the ball back. At this stage in the fourth quarter, great job by the defense, understanding exactly what the offense is trying to do. They're trying to bleed the clock, shorten the game. They completely sold out to stop the run, able to take them down for a loss.
And he's going to be taken down. An injured player down there, and that's the man they can't afford to lose. It is indeed Dak Prescott. Athletic training staff looking at him, so we'll step aside. Here's a chance to put this game away. First down and goal. Here's a run. And he's got another one. Ezekiel Elliott. Touchdown, Cowboys. That's his third touchdown of the game. And number 12 on the year. Greg, that's one of those scores where it's not completely over, but it's getting to be about that time.
Yeah, Mike, I just think they're entering miracle stage right now, and I just don't think there's any coming back from this deficit.
So now, after the touchdown, out is Aubrey to kick this one away. They're trying to pin him deep. They'll take this from the three. They get across the 20, mark them at the 22-yard line. The home team's offense getting things in order as they trot out for this next possession. Things not looking good. But see if they get the turnaround going here. They'll start this drive with first down. Cousins. That's complete to McCloud. That's a nice pickup on a first down throw. It's a gain of eight. Over the middle, that's his tight end, Pitts. And they'll whistle him down, but not before he picks up a first down. After a gain, oh, they're on him in a flash, and he's lost the football. And the defense has it.
in the pocket looking to throw the ball, but the defense was looking right at the ball. They knock it away and come up with the turnover.
Mike, we see so often a quarterback is so focused, keeping his eyes down the field, looking for one of his receivers to work himself free, that they lose track of where the defenders are. And I think that's exactly what happened here. The defender closed on him quicker than he might have thought, knocks the ball loose, creating the takeaway.
Hand off here to Zeke, and he'll be taken down as the clock ticks towards 2 minutes to play. Here's second and three to go. Again, here's Zeke, and not much there. He's back to the original line. No gain on that one. He'll come up to third and three. They'll run Zeke up the middle. The offense is staying right there. They're going for it. Fourth and a couple. They'll give it to Elliott. And he's going to have a Cowboys first down. He gets more than he needs. 4 yards picked up on fourth and two. So it's a win for the Cowboys.